Hello friends, welcome back to my YouTube channel. In today's lecture, we will learn about the concept of actions class and its uses. Before getting inside the action class, let us see an example present in this Amazon site. You can see that here, whenever I am trying to hover on Hello Gaurav, all the elements are coming, means we require to hover mouse over on the accounts and list section to get all these items. You can see that your account, your orders, your wish list, all these things are present inside the Hello Gaurav account and list, and we need to hover on it. We do not require to click on it. So we must know the concept of hovering. We will get to know of concept of hovering by knowing the concept of actions class. Again, one more thing or one more advantage of action class is that if you want to type something in capital letters, what you will do? Normally, you use caps lock and type whatever you want. Suppose that ABCD you want to type. For this, you used caps lock and typed ABCD. Similarly, in Selenium also, the actions class fulfills this requirement. It provides some methods inside it, so that you can be able to perform some actions required in keyboard and mouse. So we will get to know about all the methods present inside the actions class one by one. So let us check it. This is a PPT I have created here. You can see that I have written actions class and its uses, and here I have mentioned the syntax to use action class. We will only look into it, and afterwards whenever we will code, I will make you understand all the lines written here. Here it is written that methods of action class. You can see that double click, click and hold, drag and drop, move to element. In the present lecture, we will learn move to element method of actions class. Send keys is present to send the keys, means if you want to type inside the keyboard, using the keyboard you can use the send keys. Key up, key down, all these methods are present here. Even though you can see that it is written that context click, whenever you try to right click, you can see that whenever I am trying to right click, you can also perform this action using Selenium. So let us understand actions class using the coding part. So let us start the coding. Here I have opened the Eclipse and written some few lines of code here, where the common lines in all the code is written here. You can see that I have just written the lines which are common in all codings. You can see that it is the these are the lines present here, where I have mentioned the path of chromedriver.exe. I have created an object driver of chromedriver class and called the Amazon site, and here I have given 10 seconds as implicit wait, as you already know about the implicit wait concept. Now we will do the action class methods using the object creation of action class, which I have already told you how to create an object using any class. So let us start creating the object of actions class, and using the object of action class, we will be able to perform the functionalities or methods of action class. So let us start. We will write actions, just write actions, because actions is the name of class. Give some space and a given name, whatever you want. You can type ABCD name of your, such that my name is Gaurav, I can type actions space Gaurav also. It totally depends upon you. After this, you will type new actions, similar to the object creations which I have already told you how to do this, and semicolon. You can see that it is totally similar to this wave driver driver equal to new chrome driver, where chrome driver is the class. Similarly, actions is the class and action is the object created. Inside the argument of this, we have to pass the driver. Why we are passing the driver here? Because driver gets all the capabilities of this actions class. Whatever functions present inside the actions class will be stored inside the driver, and the capabilities of the driver and actions class will be stored inside this action object. By using this action object, you will be able to perform the functionalities or the methods of action class. You will get to know in the next line. First of all, import some things which are present in actions class. So click on it and import it, import actions. You can see that whenever we import the actions, you can see that selenium.interactions.actions, which I have already told you that the driver passed inside the actions argument got the capabilities of this actions class, and this action object gets all the capabilities to do the interactions present inside a particular web page. You can see that here it is a web page, and using the action class it will be able to get the interactions. What is the interaction here? The interaction is to mouse over on this element. I think you got the point. After getting the point, you will be able to code it very easily. It will be a cakewalk for you because you understood the concept here. You have created the action object, and using this action object, you will be able to perform the method of actions class. So move to the next line. Now we will find the wave element for which we want to mouse over. For example, here we want to mouse over in this part. So we will find the wave element of this one, locator of this one. So kindly inspect it, and you will get to know the locator of this portion. You can see that we will find the locator of this portion, and we will use to create the wave element of itself. So let us click on the arrow and take whole of this and create a locator here. You can see that a blue highlighted line came, which is A, and inside various attributes are present here. We will take ID here, ID, because ID is more reliable. So we will take ID and create a locator. So Control F, inside it give ID equal to, inside the single quote pass the ID. We paste it here, just inside the single quote paste it here. And before this you can give a bracket and another give the closing square bracket. You got the locator of this thing, whatever we want to mouse over, you got it. So let us copy it and use in the Eclipse. You can see that, just paste it here, we will use it later. Now we can give the naming convention of wave element by just typing wave element space any name you want to give, such that element we, you can give we equal to driver dot find element. And what type of locator technique we are using? CSS selector. So we will use by dot CSS selector. Inside the CSS selector, we will pass whatever locator we have created. We have created and pasted here. We will use it. And semicolon. Just cut it using Control X. Control X and paste it here. You can see that. Bracket. Yeah. I have pasted it here. So we have created a we wave element using this locator technique. So let us click on this and import the wave element. You will import the wave element here. Now you got the wave element for the thing which we want to hover. We will not do only this thing. We will try to hover in it and click on the your account section. So right clicking on this element also, and we will get to know the your account locator. You can see that span class, this one is the locator for the account section, your account section. We will click on this class because attribute present here is the class, and paste it here and check whether we are getting one of one or not. No, we are getting one of 38, which is not unique attribute. So we should use the parent child traverse relationship, which I have already told you in my previous lecture. If you haven't watched this yet, I will provide the link how to get a locator one of one whenever we require parent child traverse relationship. So do watch that lecture because it is very necessary whenever you are not getting the locator directly. So just clicking on it and click right click and your account, you can see that span. So you will follow the parent child traverse relationship, and you can see that div id, this one is the grandparent of this span class. How you will be able to know that? Whenever you will click on this arrow, it will hide. You can see that it is hidden, this span is hidden, and whenever you are trying to click on this ahref, it will be hidden. You can see that means ahref, this one is the father of this span class, and div id, this one is the grandfather of this span class. So you can use the parent child traverse relationship for creating the locator. So let us create. Just you will write using the xpath, you will write //// div bracket at the rate id equal to inside the single quote, just past whatever the locator you have used. You got it, means you have reached up to the grandparent. Now from the grandparent you will reach to the parent. By the method you have to just write a, and there are many a's present here, so you should use the indexing concept which I have already told you in my previous lecture. If you haven't watched this lecture, I will also provide the link of this indexing part. Just give the index, and what index it will be? 1, because inside the div a is the first child, so you will provide 1 here. After a1 you will provide span, and you reach this class. You can see that, and here one of one is coming. So this is the correct locator, you have found it. So just copy it and paste in the Eclipse, and we will use in the later on. You can see that we just pasted it. Now create this, not creating, I am just naming this locator. Just name it. You can copy this and just change whatever is required. You can see that instead of we, you can write we. Here you can write we1, and this will be we2. Now instead of CSS selector, you will use xpath, because we are using xpath here. So just pass xpath and just copy this one and paste it there. Control X, instead of this one you will paste it here. You can see that you have created both locators you want to use. For this you just hover on it, and you have to click on your account. So now let us use the concept of actions here. For this you will use the object whatever you have created. You have created action here, so you will use the object, and using the object you will call the methods of actions class. So just click dot, you will get all the methods present inside the action class. You can see that, and here what type of method you required? You required move to element because you want to hover. You can see that whenever you will click on dot, you will able to see that move to element, this one. Just click on it. You can also cross verify it here. You can see that here it is written that move to element, shift the mouse pointer to the center of the element. If you are not able to see, you can see that here it is written that move to element, shift the mouse pointer to the center of element, means mouse hovering is used using this concept, move to element. You can see that. Now we will use that concept and pass the locator here. What is the locator? You can see that we want to mouse over on this one, and we have found it and named it as WE1. So we will just write WE1 here. After this, you want to mouse over to this thing. You can see that you want to mouse over on this thing, and then you will click on that. So just you have to mouse over on your account. So you have to use dot move to element again. Move to element again. You have to pass the locator of the second element you want to mouse over. You want to mouse over on WE2. So you will pass WE2 here. After it, what you want to do? You want to click on this your account. So you will use the click method here. So you have to just use dot click. Dot click, you done. Now, but one question arises here. Will it be okay or will it be sufficient to write this only this thing? No. The answer is no, because the actions class uses two more set of things. First one is dot build. You have to use dot build here. Why we are using dot build here? Because dot build converts this to a thing which is ready to be executed. Means after writing dot build, this line is ready to be executed. But it is only ready to be executed. But whenever you want to do this execution, you have to just write dot perform. Again, I will tell you what I did. I just wrote whatever is required, action dot move to element. You want to move to WE1, which is this one. You want to move to element this one. Again, after this, you want to move to element your account. And this thing I have done. Move to element WE1, which is the locator of that particular element, and click on that your account. I have used move to element WE2, and just dot click because we want to click on the second element. But these two things are extra, which is required for actions class. This dot build is used to convert this line to be executable, means not executable. I will say that it will allow it to make such that it will be ready to be executed. This line will be ready to execute it. But the to be ready to be executed is not sufficient. You have to perform it. You have to execute it. And for executing it, you require dot perform. I think you got the concept. Now save it and just try to run and check whether our code is working fine or not. So just right click on it, run as Java application you will do, and you will be able to see that it will mouse over to that particular element, and after mouse overing to this one, it will click on your account. You can see that your account has been clicked. So I think you got the concept, the first concept, which I have already told you, this one. You can see that move to element means mouse overing concept I have already told you. In my next lecture, I will tell you more methods, more mouse actions of action class present. If you liked my content, please like the video, share it to your dear ones, and kindly subscribe my channel. Thank you.